Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna be showing you guys my nighttime routine for acne prone skin or scarred prone skin with or without makeup. So if you're interested in seeing my skincare nighttime routine, then keep on watching. Okay guys, so I'm coming here, you know, long day. Well, it wasn't really a long day to be honest. I was just chilling all day, but you know, hair's out, it's getting late. Got my glasses on. Actually, let me take off my glasses so we could do this properly. I have a fresh face for you guys. I literally just washed my face. So usually when I wash my face, today I was gonna do a mask, but I was like, because I'm going my mom's 50th birthday dinner tomorrow, so I wanted my skin to be pretty smooth, but my skin feels pretty smooth right now, so I don't think I need to go in with a mask right now, but I will tomorrow. But I did wash my face. So what I did, if I don't do a mask, I usually exfoliate my skin. So I go in with this right here. This is the Avène Gentle Body Scrub for sensitive skin. This stuff is goals. This stuff is amazing. This stuff works beautiful and perfect for the skin. It's gentle, but it really exfoliates and gets the dirt off the skin. So that's what I use to start washing my face. And then I normally go in usually with a gentle cleanser if I'm not wearing makeup. So I went in with the Ole Henriksen Find Your Balance Oil Control Cleanser. So I went in with this. It's just a very gentle cleanser that has like ginseng and has very cooling properties, so it feels so good on your skin at night. And so I go in with this. But if I do wear makeup, I go in with the Garnier Skin Active Micellar Water. So I usually use this on some like really, really big cotton pads. I use about 3 of these cotton pads to take off all my makeup. And then once I do that, I then cleanse my face with the Clinique Foaming Sonic Facial Soap. So I usually use this when I wear a lot of makeup or after a very long day, I've been out. Even if I wear makeup or not, I'll go in with this, and then I'll go in with my Ole Henriksen Gentle Cleanser. But if I do wear makeup, this is the first thing I start with in my cleansing routine. So this is usually my first cleanse, or maybe, is it my first cleanse or would it be my second cleanse because I did the micellar water? Whatever you think first, second is, doesn't really matter, but I go with my first cleanse with this. And then usually I go back in with the Avène Exfoliating Scrub just to really take off any excess makeup residue that's left. And then to soothe my skin and just to really cap off the night, I go in with my Ole Henriksen Facial Cleanser. So as I'm from, my skin is already feeling pretty supple, pretty soft. I don't need it. I didn't need to use a mask, but I will show you the mask that I've been loving that I use. But I did go in with the exfoliating scrub and the Ole Henriksen Cleanser. So I've done that. So now I'm gonna go in the Ole Henriksen Balancing Force Oil Control Toner. I absolutely love this stuff. This stuff has made a world of a difference on my skin since I've started using it. My skin feels a little bit smoother, brighter, just fresher since I've been using this. So I'm gonna go in with a, on the back of a cotton pad right here, not much. And then I'm just going to take off any excess dirt that I have left on my skin. Oh, I love this stuff. It feels so good, and I run it down my neck because I usually put makeup down my neck. And as you can see already, there's already, I don't know if you can see that, but there's already some residue on the cotton pad already. And usually I'll go on the opposite side and then just wipe once again and just really take off anything that is left. People think like, oh, exfoliating is just this, oh, you don't need to do it, but it really takes off any excess dirt or makeup or anything that is left on your skin. As you could see from this cotton pad, there's still quite a bit of dirt that was still left on my skin even after I exfoliated, or you know, I use my Clinique foaming cleanser or my Ole Henriksen one, I still have debris left over. And I didn't really do much today. I literally went out, did some errands for my mom's birthday, and I came back and literally have all this debris left after I washed my face. So once that is done, I have this little sample of this Lancôme eye cream that I've actually been loving. And I never used eye cream before, but I really have been seeing a difference in using some eye cream underneath my eyes. There was a day, a couple days, where I was just so tired and you could see the like fine lines underneath my eyes through my makeup, and it was creasing in those fine lines my makeup. And I used this for a couple days and my under eyes, the creasing under my under eyes kind of like diminished, and I find that like my under eyes look a little bit more supple. So I'm just gonna take a little bit of this on my finger and I'm just gonna apply some here and here, and I'm just going to gently rub that underneath my eyes. And I usually drag it down a little bit. So usually like how you do your makeup, you kind of drag it in a V. So I usually drag it quite far because I really want it to really get this under eye area. And most of us have very dry under eyes anyways, and the under eye skin is very sensitive. I just thought, let me go ahead and try this, and I actually really like this, but I do want to try the Ole Henriksen banana cream. I think it's called the banana eye cream or something like that. I heard that one is like really, really, really good. And then usually what I would go in at the end of the night, which I need to get, this is a sample or a travel size and it's completely done, and I love this stuff. This is the Ole Henriksen Counterbalance Oil Control Hydrator. This mixed with the cleanser, goals. Like, this is absolutely amazing, and it feels so good and so refreshing on your skin. Like, it is honestly the best moisturizer that I think, or nighttime moisturizer that I think I've found to this day. And so I need to go and replace this ASAP because it's really made a difference in how my skin looks and how my skin feels. But since I don't have that, I usually go in at night with my retinol. So this is by The Ordinary. This is the retinol 1% in squalane. I don't know, but this is it. I will link all the products that I use below, and it comes in this little like drip situation, so it's kind of easier to apply. This is actually almost done. So usually I apply it directly on to the face, but for the purpose of this video, I'm just gonna directly apply it to my hands. And so this helps with any darkness on your skin, helps with uneven skin tone, helps just balance everything out. And when I first started using this, this stuff was like honestly life in itself. It keeps your skin, it's good for like anti-aging and wrinkles and stuff like that, but I don't use it for that. I use it for any darkness or hyperpigmentation on my skin, because as you guys could see, I still have a lot of old scarring on my face and under my neck. So I'm trying my hardest to get rid of it. I got recommended this by one of the cosmetic girls at Shoppers about this Canadian brand skincare that really helps with like darkness and hyperpigmentation. So I'm thinking of getting that and giving it a try. But as of right now, I just want to finish the products that I have. So I'm almost done the retinol. So once that is done, I'm gonna go and get something else and try something different, because usually with skincare, after a while, you don't really see a difference because it's the same thing over and over again. So that's why it's good to have different things and switch out your products here and there, just to keep it fresh and just to keep your skin like, what? What's going on here? You know, so you can get the best results that you want. But I've noticed that from using it, that I used to have really dark pigmentation around my mouth, and that's gone down significantly. And I really do love this. I love how it feels on my skin. And even when I wake up and I wash my face in the morning, my skin feels so like smooth and supple and fresh. It's just, honestly, I just love this stuff. So usually I go in with a mask I try to do it twice a week, but usually I do it once a week every Sunday. And I usually do it after I come out the shower and my face is washed and cleansed. So I do it before I do my toner and my moisturizer. So what I've honestly been loving is the Kiehl's Rare Earth Deep Pore Cleansing Mask. This little small version right here, this is the travel size version, and this has lasted me honestly over a year now. And I absolutely love this. So it is like a clay mask, and you put it onto your skin and it hardens and it takes out any impurities, anything that's not meant to be on your skin. It just kind of sucks it out or like dries it up. So I've been really, really loving this stuff. Also, I've been loving the Glam Glow Super Mud, I think it's called. It's the one in the white packaging. Love, love that stuff. And the one in the orange packaging, the brightening one, love. Those are my two favorite ones. But those are, Glam Glow is so expensive, but like I absolutely love it. But I've been using this, I'm actually almost finished it right now. I think I'm gonna go get a full size of this because I really, really do love it. So I think I'm gonna go in with this cleanser tomorrow. On Sunday instead of today because my skin's feeling pretty good right now. And then after that I go in with the Boscia black mask. So usually I go in with any parts that have any pores. So I go around my nose, on my chin, anywhere that has is very porous or has a lot of whiteheads or blackheads and stuff to try to extract it as best as I can. So I usually do it in mainly like my T-zone area. So I go in with that, and then once that is done, to freshen up my skin or to kind of polish my skin, I go in with the Tatcha polished rice enzyme powder. This stuff is amazing, like amazing. You put some in your hand and you rub it together and you rub it in your face for about 10 to 20 seconds, and when you wash your face, you can tell your skin is polished, it's fresh, it's just like radiant. It just looks, it's amazing. It's it's expensive. Like for this little travel size, it was $20, but for the actual, I think full size one, it's a lot more. I think it's maybe about like $40, $50, maybe even $60, but it is worth it. You need a very little bit and it lasts quite a bit of time, and I absolutely love it. So sometimes I forget to use it, but lately I've been really adding it into my skincare routine after my mask, and it's really been working. Okay, so continuing on, we're kind of close to the end of my skincare routine. I usually like to go in with some Polysporin if I have any little bumps that are raised. So I have one right here that's been irritating me. So I usually like to put Polysporin on any bumps that's, or like kind of cystic looking ones or under the skin ones, with this Polysporin Heal Fast formula. Polysporin is very, very good for any type of scarring or if you have a cut or whatever. Like it's literally gone, or it's gone down within a day. So it's very good if you have like little spots. I know people like to put, you know, toothpaste, or they like to put like a little bit of a mask on those spots. You could do that as well, but Polysporin is actually the fastest thing to use. So I'm just gonna put a little bit on this spot that I have right here. Okay, so also what I like to do, oh my god, I gotta hurry up, my battery's dying. What I also like to do is I like to go in with some castor oil, a little bit of castor oil on my eyebrows, because castor oil helps the growth of your eyebrows or any hair in general. And I've noticed that ever since doing this, my eyebrows have been thicker, it has been growing, and that is the goal in life, is to have nice, healthy, thick eyebrows. So I go in with a little bit of that at night. My mom laughs at me because I look like an oil slick, but it's okay because it's working, it's getting the job done. And then to just cap off everything and get ready to get into bed, I go in with a little bit of this Blissett chapsticks on my lips at the end. Oh, love this. This has been the only thing that worked on my lips when I was on when I was on Accutane, and I've been obsessed with it. I love it. I love how it makes my lips feel, keeps my lips plump, moisturized, healthy, you know, not cracky and crusty. So I've been really loving the Blissett. All right, guys, so that is it for my nighttime skincare routine. I hope this video was helpful in any way. Maybe there's some products that you guys wanted to try but never tried, or want to get into skincare for acne skin and but you don't know what to use. So these are the products that have been working for me. Not all products are going to work for everybody, but you got to try different ones to see what really works for you, and I'm definitely learning that as I go along. So let me know in the comments if there's anything that you're going to try, or things that you've been using, or anything, any suggestions of any things that I should try for myself. Let me know in the comments below. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys in my next upload. Mwah! Bye, guys.